Hello friends, this is Gangadhar from Dimensions Guntur to explain quantitative questions from SSC CGL 7th paper. First question is 51st question. When I distribute a packet of chocolates to 7 students, I am left with 4 chocolates. When I distribute the same packet of chocolates to 11 students, I am left with 6 chocolates. How many chocolates will be left with me if I distribute the same packet of chocolates among 13 students? Okay, so when I distribute certain number of chocolates to 7 students, I am left with 7 chocolates. That means if the number of chocolates with me is some n, when that n is divided by 7, I left with 4. Okay, so by converting it into the general division form, when I divided n with 7, we left with the remainder 4. That was first statement. Coming to the second statement, when I divide the number of chocolates n with 11, I left with a remainder of 6 chocolates. So this is the second statement. Okay, so we need to find out the value of n by satisfying these two conditions, and then they asked us the number of chocolates will be left with me if I distribute the same packet among 13 students. That means first of all we need to find out the value of n, and then we have to divide that n with 13. The remainder is the answer. Okay, since n is divided by 11, remainder is 6. From this, n can be expressed as n is equals to some 11 multiple 11 into some k plus 6. So n is equals to 11 into some k plus 6. Okay, so among this, for different values of k, we have different values of n. Among these values of n, for certain value of n, when it is divided by 7, leaves remainder 4. For example, if k is equals to 1, then n is equals to 7. If k is equals to 2, 22 plus 6, it is 28. If k is equals to 3, 33 plus 6, 39. If k is equals to 4, 44 plus 6, 50. Like this, we have different values of n. Among all those, we have to divide n with 7. If you divide 17 with 7, the remainder is 3. 28 with 7, the remainder is 0. 39 with 7, the remainder is 4. So our value of n is 39. But the question is, when we divide n with 13, 39 divided by 30 leaves a remainder of 0. So I am left with no chocolates. So our answer is 0. This is first problem of 7th paper. And next one is 52nd question. It is given that in a maternity center, 5% of all the child birth cases results in twins. Okay, so twin cases are how much? 5%. 5% ante out of 100, 5 cases are twins. Okay, and the remaining 95 cases are normal deliveries. Okay, so that means out of 100 newly born children, out of 100 newly birth cases, 95 are normal children and 5 cases are twins. Kabatti aa cases lo vachinatundi 10 children are twins. Ante totally there are 10 children who are twins among 105 students. 95 usual children and 10 children from 5 twin cases. Okay, so totally they asked us to calculate the percentage of twins out of total children born antunadu. Okay, twin children are 10, 5 cases are twin cases, so it leads to 10 children. Total number of children are normally 95 plus this 10 will give us 105. 10 by 105 into 100 will give us the required percentage, and your answer is approximately 9.5%. Okay, this is 52nd problem. Then 53rd. Okay, 53rd problem. In a laboratory, a sample of air, which is a mixture of oxygen and water vapor, is taken. Water vapor contains hydrogen and oxygen gases. If air contains a total of 70% oxygen, okay, including that contained in the water vapor by weight, whereas water vapor contains 16.66% of oxygen by weight, then how many kilograms of water vapor is present in 1 kg of air is the question. Okay, for example, okay, if you have air of 1 kg, in this 1 kg of air we have oxygen as well as water vapor. In this water vapor we have oxygen along with the hydrogen. Okay, the oxygen from these two cases contains 70% of the weight. Okay, so that 70% in the sense, it leads to 700 grams. Okay, so automatically the remaining hydrogen is of 30%, which leads to 300 grams. Okay, and And they also mentioned that whereas water vapor contains 16.66% of oxygen, ee water vapor lo oxygen hydrogen undiga ee rendittlo this oxygen is 16.66%. 16.66% means 1/6 anamata. So 16.66 ante 1/6 kabatti then its hydrogen is 5/6. So that means this 300 grams is equals to 5/6 of the quantity of the water vapor, that is equal to 300 grams. And on simplification, you will get that water vapor as 360 grams and your answer is 0.36. Okay. And the next question is 54th question. For this 54th question, the interest in the first two successive years were 400 rupees and 420 rupees respectively. When a sum of money is invested at compound interest, we need to find the sum. Okay. Then 54th question. So for the first year the interest is 400, for the at the end of second year the interest is 420. So 20 rupees rise vachindi. Enduku 20 rupees rise vachindi? Because ee 400 rupees kuda interest calculate cheyadam valla 20 rupees rise vachindi. Ante after the completion of first year and to the end of second year, the interest calculated on the 400 rupees is 20 rupees. That means since the difference is 20 rupees, it is given that 20 rupees on 400 rupees for 1 year is mentioned. 20 rupees on 400 rupees for 1 year is mentioned. From this we can calculate the rate of interest. For 1 year, compound interest and simple interest both are same, whereas the rate of interest is nothing but 100 I by PT. Okay, so 100 into what is the interest? 20 rupees, whereas the principal is 400 and the time is 1 year. Okay, and if you calculate, what you will get? Okay, two zeros will get calculate, two zeros will get cancelled, and then 4 5s, the rate of interest is 5%. Since the rate of interest is 5%, next the question is we need to calculate the sum. Okay, so for 1 year, for the first year the interest is 400 rupees on the principal. That principal we need to calculate. This is not actual principal, this is the principal for this 20 rupees of interest. But for 400 rupees of interest we need to calculate the principal amount. Okay, for 1 year compound interest is equals to simple interest. So to calculate the principal directly we can use the logic that 100 I by RT. Okay, whereas for the first year the interest amount is 400 rupees and we are going to calculate the principal amount and the rate of interest is mentioned as 5, whereas time is 1 year. So okay, we need to simplify this one, and on simplification you will get it as 8000 rupees. So the principal amount is 8000 rupees. This is 54th question. And the next one is 55. It is given that a shopkeeper calculated his profit on the market price and finds it to be 30%. Okay, for example, if you treat market price is equals to some x, then the profit is mentioned as 30% of the market price. Okay, so but what is profit actually? Profit is actually selling price minus cost price, which is equals to 30% of x. Okay, and I mentioned that he forgets the fact that he gave a discount of 20%. Discount ichina vishayam marchipoyadu. Discount ichina vishayam marchipothe selling price is equals to market price, so this is also x. Since this is x, this is 30% of x, we can calculate cost price as x minus 30% of x, nothing but 70% of x. So finally the cost price is 70% of x. But actually what is happening, he forgets the fact that he gave a discount of 20%. Actually he gave a discount of 20%, so selling price is equals to 80% of the market price x. This is the cost price, whereas this is the selling price, and we are going to calculate the profit percentage. The difference is 10 divided by 70 into 100, we need to calculate. And on calculation your answer is 14.2/7%. Okay, this is 55th problem. And the next one is 56. It is given that 40 persons can finish a work in 60 days. 40 persons can finish a work in 60 days. So the work done by those 40 people in 60 days is 40 into 60. Whereas if 40 persons start the work and at the end of every 10 days more, 40 more persons of the same efficiency join them, how long will it take to complete the work? Okay, so 40 persons 60 days continuous ga work chesthe work complete aipothundi. Ala kaakunda ade work ni first 40 persons start chesi every 10 days ki inkoka 40 persons add avutu elthe enni days lo complete avutundi antunnaru. Ante first 10 days totally 40 persons work chestaru. Okay, next 10 days 80 persons work chestaru. నెక్స్ట్ 10 డేస్ 120% వర్క్ చేస్తారు. లైక్ దిస్ వీ విల్ కంటిన్యూ. సో ఇలా కంటిన్యూ చేస్తే ఎన్ని రోజులు పడుతున్నట్టున్నాడు. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఇఫ్ యూ అబ్జర్వ్ ద ఫస్ట్ 3 కేసెస్, ఇఫ్ యూ పికౌట్ ద 10 అవుట్, 40, 80, 120. 120 + 120 ఈజ్ వాట్? 240. దిస్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో 2400. దిస్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో 2400. బోత్ ఆర్ సేమ్. సో దెన్ ఇట్స్ 10 + 10 + 10, 30 డేస్ టు కంప్లీట్ ద వర్క్. ఓకే, 30 డేస్ ఈజ్ యువర్ ఆన్సర్. దెన్ ఫర్ ద 57th ప్రాబ్లం, ఇట్ ఈస్ మెన్షన్ దట్ ఏ రన్స్ 1.75 టైమ్స్ యాజ్ ఫాస్ట్ యాజ్ బి. ఏ రన్స్ 1.75 టైమ్స్ యాజ్ ఫాస్ట్ యాజ్ బి. సో దేర్ స్పీడ్స్ రేషియో ఇన్ ద రేషియో 1.75:1. సో 175/100, 175 25 7s, అండ్ దెన్ 25 4s. సో దేర్ స్పీడ్స్ రేషియో ఈజ్ ఇన్ 7:4. నౌ దే ఆస్క్డ్ అస్ ఇఫ్ ఏ గివ్స్ బి ఎ స్టార్ట్ ఆఫ్ 60 మీటర్స్, అంటే బి ఒక 60 మీటర్స్ ట్రావెల్ చేసిన తర్వాత ఏ స్టార్ట్ అయితే, హౌ ఫార్ షుడ్ ద విన్నింగ్ పోస్ట్ బి, సో ద విన్నింగ్ పోస్ట్ బి సో దట్ ఏ అండ్ బి రీచ్ దేర్ ఎట్ ద సేమ్ టైమ్. సో ఒక విన్నింగ్ పోస్ట్ని ఏ అండ్ బి ఇద్దరు రీచ్ అయ్యారు, సేమ్ టైంలో రీచ్ అయ్యారు, బట్ వాటి స్పీడ్స్ రేషియోలో ఉన్నాయి. ఓకేనా? అండ్ మన హౌ ఫార్ షుడ్ ద విన్నింగ్ పోస్ట్ డిస్టెన్స్ మనం క్యాలిక్యులేట్ చేయాల్సి ఉంటుంది. ఓకే, సిన్స్ ఏ అండ్ బి ఆర్ రీచింగ్ ద విన్నింగ్ పోస్ట్ ఎట్ ద సేమ్ టైమ్, సో టైమ్ టేకెన్ ఫర్ ద బోత్ ద పీపుల్ ఆర్ సేమ్. సో T1 = T2. ఓకే, సో T1 ఈజ్ డిస్టెన్స్ బై స్పీడ్ D1/S1, T2 ఈజ్ డిస్టెన్స్ బై స్పీడ్ D2/S2. Whereas the speeds are given in the ratio 7:4, so we need to take them as 7 and 4. Coming to the distances, so A has to cover a distance of x and speed is 7, but B has to cover, A gives B a start of 60 meters, so B has to cover x minus 60 meters and his speed is 4. So x/7 = x - 60/4, and on cross multiplication, on simplification, you will get the value of x, which is 140 meters. This is 57th problem. And the next one is 58. In the 58, it is given that water is filled in a container in such a manner that its volume doubles for every 5 minutes. For every 5 minutes, its volume is doubled. If it takes 30 minutes for the container to be full, in how much time will it be 1/4 full? Okay? Initially, let the volume is V. After 5 minutes, it's doubled, 2V. After 10 minutes, 4V. After 15 minutes, 8V. After 20 minutes, 16V. 25 minutes, 32V, and then after 30 minutes, its volume is 64 times of the original volume. Okay? But one, and a tank full of water, 64 times avali. And if it take, in how much time will it be 1/4 full? 1/4 of 64V, and a, which is nothing but 16V. Okay? 16V, they can reach a while, it needs 5, 10, 15, and 20 minutes. So your answer is 20 minutes. That was your answer. And the next one is 59th problem. And this 59th problem gives us, the cost of 3 apples and 2 guavas is 23 rupees. So let the apple cost is A and the guava cost is G. So 3 apples and 2 G is equals to 23. Whereas the cost of 1 apple and 4 guavas of the same types is 21. Okay, 1 apple. So A plus 4 guavas is 4 G is equals to 21. We need to calculate the cost of 5 guavas. From this, on a simplification, we need to get the value of G. So multiply the second equation with 3 and do subtraction. From there you will get the value of G is equals to some 4 rupees. Since the cost of 1 guava is 4 rupees, they asked us the cost of 5 guavas, which is nothing but 20 rupees. So this is 59th problem. Okay. And the next one is 60th one, which is from the equations type. They mentioned that for an equation x² + x + 2 is equals to 0, the roots are alpha and beta. They asked us to calculate α/10 + β/10 divided by α - 10 + β - 10. This is what we need to calculate. Okay? So α - 10 is 1/α/10. β - 10 is 1/β/10. α/10 + β/10 divided by 1/α/10 + 1/β/10. Took LCM. And then if you do simplification, you get it as α/β/10. If the quadratic equation has 2 roots alpha and beta, then from there it is clear that the product of the roots is constant by the x² coefficient, which is 2. Since α/β is 2, this is 2/10, and your answer is 1024. Okay? Right. This is 60th problem. Then coming to 61st problem. Okay? Right. 61st one. The greatest possible number of points of intersection of 8 straight lines and 4 circles we need to calculate. We have 8 straight lines and then 4 circles. Okay, we need to calculate the greatest possible number of points. among these eight straight lines, every two lines will give us 1 point. Okay, every two lines will give us 1 point. So the number of ways of selection of two lines out of these eight we need to calculate. Okay, which can be expressed as 8 × 7/2, the direct rule. Among these four circles, every two circles will give us 2 points. Okay, so every two circles will give us 2 points. Number of ways of selection of two circles from these four circles is 4 × 3/2, plus one straight line. When it intersects one circle, maximum it gives 2 points. Okay, one straight line with one circle, totally the combination possible with 8 × 4 times. In every case, we have 2 points × 2, and on simplification you will get, okay, 2 × 4 and 7 × 4 = 28. 2 and 2 will get cancelled. This is 12. 8 × 4 = 32 × 2 = 64. And if you simplify, your answer is 104. That was your answer. Okay, and the next one is 62nd one. 62nd one is from circles. It is given that PQRS is a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, if we have a circle, okay, PQR is an equilateral triangle. We have an equilateral triangle whose name is PQR, and PQRS is a cyclic quadrilateral. That means S is a point on the circle such that everything is making a quadrilateral. They asked us to calculate RSP, this angle, and since it is an equilateral triangle, this angle is clearly 60. Since this angle is 60, the opposite angle is 180 degrees minus 60, which is 120 degrees. Okay, there is the problem. And coming to 63rd problem, in a triangle, the lengths of the larger sides are mentioned as 8 centimeters and 7 centimeters. Larger side, one is 8 centimeters and the other one is 7 centimeters, and the third one we don't know, let it as some x centimeters. Okay, so this is the middle side. The angles of a triangle are in arithmetic progression. If the angles are in arithmetic progression, if the angles are in arithmetic progression, then the middle angle B is equals to 60 degrees. So if the angle B is equal to 60 degrees, we need to apply cosine rule to find x. Two sides and one angle is known. Okay. So to apply cosine rule, cos 60 degrees. Cos 60 degrees is cos B, which is nothing but cos B is the middle angle. It relates to this 7. So cosine rule is 8 square plus x square minus 7 square divided by 2 × 8 × x, whereas cos 60 degrees is 1/2. These 2 and the 2 will get cancelled, and on cross multiplication you will get a quadratic equation. If you solve it, you will get the value of x is either 5 or 3 centimeters, right? So the next one is 54th question. It is mentioned that a spherical ball was painted black. After getting painted, it was cut into 4 smaller pieces. What is the ratio of the painted area to the non-painted area, they are asking. Okay, actually the ball is completely painted with black. Ball in the sense completely local gall untundi. Okay na, and it is nothing but just a leather cloth type anamata. When we cut into 4 smaller pieces, okay, itu pakkana area ento untundo local kuda almost ante area untundi. It's just like a cloth idi. Cloth ki both sides same area untundi kabatti. Okay na, so the painted area to the non-painted area, the ratio is 1:1. Okay, then 65th problem. It is given that from the top of a lighthouse of 60 meters high, there is a lighthouse whose height is 60 meters. With its base on the sea level, the angle of depression of a boat is 15 degrees. The angle of depression of a boat is 15 degrees. Since the angle of depression, we need to mention it as 15. So this is also 15 degrees. And they ask us to calculate the distance of the boat from the foot of the house. We need to calculate this x. Directly, if you apply tan 15 degrees, tan 15 degrees is equals to opposite side divided by the adjacent side. So x is equals to 60 divided by the value of tan 15 degrees is 2 − √3. Okay, so to rationalize it, that means we need to multiply both the numerator and the denominator with 2 + √3. 2 − √3 and the 2 + √3 is 1. So your answer is 60 times of the 2 + √3. Okay, there ends the problem. And the next one is 66th one. For this 66th problem, seats for mathematics, physics and biology in a school are in the ratio 5:7:8. There is a proposal to increase the seats by 40%, 50% and 75% respectively. Will be the ratio of the increased seats? They asked us the ratio between the increased seats. Okay, mathematics seats are increased by 40%. So let them as 140/100, which is nothing but 40/10 × 5 = 2. Physics seats are increased by 50%. 150%, so 15/10 × 7 = 2. And then biology seats are increased by 175%, so which is nothing but 175/100 × 8. we need to calculate the ratio. Okay, 10, 10, 10, 1, 0 will get cancelled. Okay, and the next task, 5. Okay, 5, 5 threes, and then 5 threes is 15, 5 fives is 25. Next task is 7. Okay, 7 twos, okay, 7 ones, and then 7 fives. Okay, and then still we have here 10. Okay, 5 twos is 10, 2 fours is 8. So 2 is 2, 3 is 2, 4 is your answer. Okay, that was the ratio. And then 67th problem. For the 67th problem, the mean of A, B and C is M. Since the mean of A, B and C is M, their sum is 3M. And also they mentioned that A, B plus B, C plus C, A is equals to 0. Okay, so since A plus B plus C is 3M, A, B plus B, C plus C, A is 0. If you square the first equation on both sides, directly you will get that A square plus B square plus C square is equals to 9m square. Since the sum of these three terms is 9m square, their mean is 3m square. That is 67th problem. Okay. Then 68th problem, it is from trigonometry. Okay. The problem involves with the very usual identity, sine square x plus cos square x is 1. Okay. For that, they mentioned that sine x plus sine square x is equals to 1. Okay. If you send this sine square x that side, it will become like sine x is equals to 1 minus sine square x. 1 minus sine square x is nothing but cos square x. And they ask us to calculate what? Cos power 8x plus 2 cos power 6x plus cos power 4x. That's what they asked us to calculate. Okay. So usually cheskuntu velthe easy answer cheyalem. It needs certain logic. So okay, we need to express it as cos power 8x plus 2 cos power 6x as cos power 6x plus cos power 6x plus cos power 4x. Then from these first two terms, you need to common out what? Cos power 4x common with them. Then we left with cos power 4x plus cos square x. Then from these two terms, you need to simplify, you need to common out cos square x, which is nothing but cos power 4x plus cos square x. See, cos square x is sin x. Okay, then cos power 4x is sin square x. Cos power 4x is sin square x. Sin square x plus cos square x is 1. Sin square x plus cos square x is 1. And again, this cos power 4 can be expressed as sin square x. Again, sin square x plus cos square x. Your final answer is 1. Okay, so we are using sin x as cos square x, cos power 4x as sin square x, and sin square x plus cos square x is equals to 1. Finally, your answer is 1. This is 68th question. Then coming to 69th question. 69th question is of trapezium. Okay, O is the intersection for the diagonals AC and BD of a trapezium. For example, if we have a trapezium whose name is, trapezium means these two are parallel, whose name is ABCD, and O is the intersection of the diagonals AC and BD. This is the O. Okay, in trapezium, these two triangles act like similar triangles. So in trapezium, diagonals divides in proportionally. So we have a logic that OA by OB is equals to OC by OD. Okay, OA is given as 3, OB is given as 4. We need to calculate OC and OD is equals to 8. 4 2s, 2 3s, and the answer is 6. Okay, and the next one is 70th problem. For 70th problem, in radius of a right angle triangle having dimensions 9, 40 and 41 is given. Okay, so the direct rule is if you have a right angle triangle of the sides A, B and C, then in radius can be calculated as A plus B minus C by 2. Directly we need to the logic. If you apply this one, 90 plus 40 minus 41 divided by 2. 49 minus 41 is 8 by 2 is 4, and your answer is 4. This is 70th problem. Then 71 to 75, okay, depends on the bar graph. The bar graph contains two bars for each and every year. One indicates the production of pulses in Kharif, and the other indicates the production of pulses in Rabi season. Okay, 71st problem. What was the average of Kharif production of the given years? Okay, for the given years 11, 12, it is 5, and the next one it is 4.75, and next it is 4.25, and next it is 3.5, and the last it is 5, whole divided by 5 for the 5 years. Okay, and on simplification, we will get the average of the Kharif as 4.5 million tons. Okay, the next one is 72nd one. What was the percentage decrease in the Rabi production from 13-14 to 14-15? 13-14, the Rabi production is second bar indicates 8, and 14-15, Rabi production is 6. The percentage decrease is 8 minus 6 divided by 8 into 100. And your answer is 25%. Okay. And the next one is 73rd problem. For the 73rd, the difference between the Rabi and Kharif production was minimum in which of the following years? Okay, in each and every year, if you observe the difference between the two bars, okay, the difference between the two bars is minimum at the last year. That means 15, 16. So clearly that one is your answer, 2015, 16. And the next one is 74th problem. What is the difference between the Rabi production in 13-14 and the average Rabi production? We need to calculate the average Rabi production. So you need to calculate average means sum of all the production in the Rabi divided by the 5, that will give the average. And then average Rabi production is 6.6 and in 13-14 the production is 8. The difference is 1.4 and your answer is none of these. And the last one is 75th problem. For that 75th problem, the Kharif production was approximately what percentage of Rabi production in 12-13? In 12-13, we need the Kharif production is 4.75. When it is compared with the 6, divided by 6 into 100, we need to calculate. 4.7 by 6 into 100 is your answer. Okay? So, this is the explanation for quantitative questions from SSC CGL 7th paper. Thank you. Thank you very much.